discussed up to the basic working principle of laser. We have explained the important terms related to laser like population, inversion, metastasis rate, etc. Now we will move on to the important parts of a laser system. For a laser system to be set up, these important parts should be there or must be there in order to occur the lasing action. So the important parts are, the first one is active medium, and second one is pumping system, and the third one is optical resonator.
So what is mean by active medium?
That is the medium containing active atoms or ions. The type of laser is identified by the name of type of active medium. Accordingly, there are solid state laser, gas lasers, and semiconductor lasers. So we know what is happening in the lasing action. Some of the atoms in the medium are exciting to higher energy level, and then population inversion, then stimulated emission, etc. So this energy level excitations of atoms are taking place inside the medium. So the medium in which these processes are taking place is known as the active medium, which contains atoms or ions. Okay, this medium can be of different types, maybe of solid type or liquid type, or gas type. Now there are dye type, semiconductor type, etc. So according to the type of or nature of the medium we are using, the laser is named as solid state laser if the medium is in the state of solid, or gas laser if the medium in the case of gas, and semiconductor laser if the medium is in the form of semiconductor. Okay, so this is one important part of the laser system, where the energy level excitation and de-excitation processes are taking place. Okay, now the second part is pumping system. What is meant by pumping? The process of supplying energy to a system so as to create the condition of population inversion is called pumping. Depending on the method in which the energy is supplied, there are several types of pumping, like thermal pumping, optical pumping, electrical pumping, chemical pumping, etc. So in order for the excitation of atoms from the lower energy level to higher energy levels, the atoms need some energy. Usually at normal temperature, all the atoms will be in the ground state, that's the minimum energy stable state. So in order to get excited to higher energy level, it needs some energy. So the energy must be supplied from outside, either by photons or by some other means. So this so the process of supplying energy to that system, in order for raising this energy to higher energy level and hence to create the condition of population inversion, is known as pumping. And system used for pumping is known as pumping system. So depending upon the method which is using for pumping action, there are several types of pumping, like thermal pumping. Thermal pumping means the energy is given by heating the system, which is quite clear from the name itself. Thermal. Thermal means heat. So we are supplying energy to the atoms or ions in the medium by supplying heat to the system. So it is known as thermal pumping. Optical pumping means the energy source is light. So light or photons are induced into the medium so that it gets energy. And electrical pumping means energy is supplied by means of electrical energy. That is, we are connecting the medium to a power supply, so that electrical energy is passing through the medium and the atoms or ions in the medium gets energy. And chemical pumping. Chemical pumping means by means of inducing some chemical reactions inside the medium, so that the reactions in such a way that they are exothermic, and the from the exothermic reaction Exothermic reaction means thermal energy is produced during the reaction, and hence the atoms or ions in the medium gets energy. So these are the several types of pumping mechanism used in the laser system. And the third important parts of the laser system is optical resonator. Optical resonator is a two mirror arrangement, that is one length tube, that is a lengthy tube on which on the two sides of this tube two mirrors are arranged, and each mirror is silver or polished. One at one end it is partially silver, and at the other end it is fully silvered or polished. In order to produce an amplified light from the laser system, you will come to know how this is acting as an optical resonator, or how this mirror arrangement act as an optical resonator in order to produce amplified light. I will explain. Okay, while explaining the working of the laser. Okay, so these three parts are very important in laser system. If these three parts are there in the system, then only if we can produce a laser light from a laser system. Okay, so different types of lasers already we have explained. Depending upon the medium we are, type of medium we are using, there are different types of laser light. Like solid state laser, example is Rubi laser. Rubi laser is a solid state laser, where Rubi is used as crystal rod in a solid form. It was constructed first by Theodor Neymar in 1960. And gas state laser, an example of gas state laser is helium neon laser, and which is first created by Ali Java in 1961. And liquid state laser, there are liquid state laser and semiconductor laser, dye laser, etc. I have just quoted the name of such laser, that is liquid state laser. European chelate laser is an example for liquid state laser, and indium phosphide laser is an example for semiconductor laser. Here the medium is a semiconductor material, and here the medium is in the form of liquid. Okay, so we will explain in detail the Rubi laser and helium neon laser, which are the example for solid state laser and gas state laser respectively, and we will not explain these two. These are out of your syllabus, so we will explain the working of Rubi laser and helium neon laser. Okay, so here in this picture I have shown different lasers which produces different colors. Just to show you the image of a image of different color lasers. Okay. So now we will describe what is Rubi laser and how it works. Okay. Now Rubi laser, the output of the Rubi laser is red in color. So you might have seen red light lasers. So it will we will get red amplified light, red amplified coherent source of light from the Rubi laser. So in the Rubi crystal, the picture of the Rubi laser system is shown here. Here the crystal is aluminium oxide. Rubi crystal is used. Here is the Rubi rod. Yes, here is the Rubi rod, and this coil is a helical flash lamp, which is xenon flash lamp, and this is a glass tube, and at the end of which the glass plates are one end is, this is partially, sorry, this is the glass tube, and at the end of the Rubi rod this is a partially silvered mirror is attached here, and fully silvered mirror is attached, and this xenon flash lamp is attached to a power supply. So here electrical pumping is used for pumping mechanism. Okay, and the acting medium is in the form of solid. So this is a solid type, solar type laser which is using electrical pumping mechanism for pumping action. Here is ruby rod is a synthetic ruby crystal, that is aluminium oxide doped with chromium 3 plus ions. That is a minor amount of chromium 3 plus ions as an impurity added to the aluminium oxide crystal, and which is synthetic crystal, ruby crystal, and that is used here as the active medium. And ruby is taken in the form of here the ruby rod is taken in the form of a tube here. This is the tube of 4 cm length and 0.5 cm in diameter, and the two ends of the rods are polished. Here it is partially polished or partially silvered, and this is completely silvered. And this system is acting as optical resonator here. And this xenon flashlamp connected to power supply. So whenever it is connected to the power supply, so I will explain the working. So these are the structure of the ruby laser. Okay. Now how it works. So when the power supply is switched on, this flash lamp, light from the xenon flash lamp is absorbed by the chromium 3 plus ions in the medium. So ruby crystal is aluminium oxide crystal doped with the chromium 3 plus ions. So when the xenon flash lamp is on, the light from the xenon flash lamp is absorbed by the chromium 3 plus ion, and it gets excited from the ground state. There is a mismatch of notations here. E0 state means E1, that is the ground state, and this is E3 state, which is I actually mean this E3 excited state. So make note the difference of these notations here in this text and this figure. Here this what I mean is whenever xenon flash lamp is on, the chromium 3 plus ions absorbs energy from the xenon flash lamp and get excited from the ground state, from this state to this excited state here. Okay, whatever the notation, E1 or E3 or E0 or A1, the meaning is it gets excited from the ground state to the excited state. And here these excited atoms are very short in their lifetime, of the order of 10 to the power minus 9 seconds, and and it will undergo a non-radioactive transition immediately to an immediate intermediate energy state here. So this ruby crystal rod is a system possessing metastable energy states. We can use only those systems which have a metastable energy state for laser system. Then only the population inversion condition can be achieved and laser action can take place. So ruby crystal is such a material possessing metastable state. So from this excited state, it gets de-excited by non-radiative, without producing much energy, to the metastable energy state, where it can stay for a long time. The metastable state here I have noted as EM. Here in this picture it is E2, so you should understand that it is the metastable state. And here it is stable for some time, of the order of 10 to the power minus 3 seconds or like that, and which is greater than the lifetime here. And so a population inversion is taking place between these two energy level. Okay. And the excited atoms are here and it comes to here. And whenever some of the atoms in this excited energy levels levels undergo spontaneous emission, or whenever atoms emit spontaneously, that energy is absorbed by these atoms in this metastable state, and hence undergo radiative transition to the ground level. So what happens is this spontaneous emission of these excited atoms to causes an induced or stimulated emission of the atoms in the metastable state. So this atom. So this produces, or a single atom can produce, sorry, single photon can produce two photons at the output, like we have explained in the stimulated emission process. And this, and at this stage, the two photons are emitted, and they will get constructively interfere if because the emitted photon and the stimulating photons are in same phase, so they will get interfere constructively, and we will get an coherent amplified light at the output. That's how we get an amplified light at the output. And the chromium ion produces red light of wavelength 693.4 nanometer. Okay, so this is the working principle of Roby laser. Hope you have understood the working. So what's happening is the energy level transition between the chromium 3 plus ions, and the energy released by these chromium 3 plus ions is in the range of red wavelength, that is of the order of this 693.4 nanometer, and the light is red in color. And this stimulated emission is enhanced by some of the spontaneous emission of the excited atoms in this excited energy level. So this is how a Roby laser is working. Okay. And this is for today. We will explain the helium